Welcome back to Alchemilla. We've just gotten the keys to all of the apartments here. So let's go open up the doors on floor 3. Let's see what fresh horrors await. That's for 302. This one apparently needs a special key. Interesting. Do I hear a phone ringing? Yes. I didn't see that phone before. Hold it. Have I gone in here before? This must be the place I got opened up because I dialed the phone number. It's still ringing? I guess it's still ringing. From when I called. What the hell was that? Good question. I don't think I want to go back to that room where I called from. There's something in there. Though, perhaps I need to go back. What was that? I need a key to the box. And I actually picked up a locked box, didn't I? No idea what to do with it, though. For some reason, that one I can't pick up. That's the exit back out of here. Happy birthday! Such a festive place. There's some kind of a notch here. Looks like something's missing. This place is very red. I I think they developed photos here. And I do have a roll of film that I got from that camera. So maybe I can get it developed. Don't know how to use this equipment. This is a picture of a cat. Don't know how to use any of it. Okay, so I definitely need to develop film here, but I guess I can't do it yet. Need to wait for something? Maybe I need to find a note that explains the process or something? Because actually, I don't even know how to develop film. I know you need to put it through various fluids, various baths, which is what these are for. If I drop the box from this height, it would break. Wait, what box? Oh, here we go. After all their preparations are complete, you can then develop the photograph. Don't forget to only use red light or else the negatives will become overexposed. Load the film into the drum and fill the drum with chemical A, then print the photographs in the enlarger. Once printed, dip the photograph into the white tray filled with chemical A2. Afterwards, dip the photo into the blue tray containing chemical B, wash the photo in the green tray with water. And finally, allow it to dry. Oh god, these are gonna be the photographs that came from the camera that was pointing at the freaking meat hooks. I really don't want to know what's on them. Okay, so A. Then put it into the enlarger. Then A2. And then B. And then water. Oh, that's probably what getting the water working was for, so I can wash it. And there's chemical A1. A2 and B. Okay, I think I have everything for that then. Bottle full of water. Okay, yeah, I think that's the reason for doing what I did in the basement. Is just so I could do that. Finished. Finished what? Oh, it is actually full of liquid. I couldn't even really tell. It's so faint. But you can just barely see the liquid in the tray. Okay, so load it into the drum. Can't use a flashlight now. Oh, right. Did I load it into the drum, I guess? Put it into the enlarger. Yep. Oh, I'm already starting to see what it looks like. Now it's fixed. Now we wash it. And then... okay. Lovely. And... I think... I need to recreate that, don't I? Because I've actually found all of those. I found two, like, stuffed teddy bears and a doll. In the apartments, I think. I think I need to go track down those things. Okay, yeah. Well, isn't that just lovely? Question is, though, where were they? I don't remember exactly, I just know that they're throughout the apartment. Well, let's keep checking out these doors, see if I can open any more. Guess I've already been in here. Yeah. Wait, what? You know, I was wondering what I was gonna do with that locked box that I picked up, but it's meant to be put in the garbage chute? Is that so it breaks open at the bottom? That's a really roundabout way of opening a box. Couldn't I just, like, pick up a cinder block or some heavy object and bash it open? Okay. Thank God I found that, because if I didn't find that, I never would have thought of it. I certainly wasn't thinking of that when I tried to use it, I've now just gotten in the habit of mashing the use button on everything. Just in case something like that happens. Okay, well, let's go find out what's inside of that box. I believe it's on floor 2 where it's, where the garbage chute is, stuffed full. Yeah, there we go. Ah, a little key. No idea what door it's for. Not this one. On floor 3, where there's a bunch of doors that just don't open. They're still locked, despite the keychain that I have, so it's probably up there, where this key is for. Still can't do anything with that tape. I think at some point I'm gonna be able to do something with it. That, or maybe it was a puzzle that they intended to have and they maybe deleted it, but then just left the item there. Because it definitely looks like it's something you're supposed to be able to pick up. Keys and all for that. Not for that either. Hmm. You know, I should be exploring these rooms that I'm entering because I need to look for those dolls. I really don't remember where the dolls were. Okay, well I'm gonna look for what door this key is for, and I'm also gonna look for all of those dolls and see if I can pick them up. So I'm gonna go do that and I'll be right back. Oh, right, maybe the small key is for this box. It is. Is that a plate? A silver plate. Maybe it's for the indentation? Because there were two indentations in that thing in one of the rooms that could be opened, right? So then, don't I need another one? Hmm. And I can't pick up any of these other plates, right? No. Interesting. Here's one of the dolls that I need. There we go, so this is actually in the room where I'm supposed to use them. see if there's any more in here. I'm pretty sure they're not all in here. Or, oh no, they are all in here. Thank God for that. Okay, we should be able to make this happen, whatever this is. A door opened up. Oh, the chest opened up. There's the other plate. Okay, so I need to use those two plates on the indentations in that thing in one of the rooms. I don't remember which room had that, though. Alright, I'm just gonna get the hell out of here. Oof, that room. Alright, so I'm gonna keep looking for that place, because I can't remember where it is. Here it is. It's the happy birthday place. A key to a room. How helpful. A key to what room? If only it had the number of the place it was to. What do you bet it's to the room that has the room number fallen off? Which one was that? Was that on floor 2? Let's see. Or was it this one? Oh, it was this one. Yeah, what do you bet it's to this? What do you know? Of course it is. I don't know how long I've been here. Looks like this was written by a kid. The sun doesn't shine into this place. This room cursed. It's disappeared. I'm locked in this small corridor. I tried to make a hole into Andy's room, but I'm too weak and don't have the energy. If I stay much longer, I will disappear too. The sun doesn't shine into this place. This room is cursed. I try to make a hole into Andy's room, but I'm too weak. Maybe I'm strong enough to make a hole? I don't know. There must be something in this place that allows me to continue, because the key I just found takes me here. So something here must allow me to continue on. Oh, wait a minute. Oh shit, I'm trapped. This wasn't here before. I just walked down this hallway and now it's closed behind me. Okay. I guess I'm stuck in this corridor now too. Yeah, this is the hole into Andy's room that he was trying to make. Okay. Can I finish the job? Ah. White Claudia. Native plant, found on the shores of Toluca Lake in Silent Hill. Blooming in the middle of June, they are known for their white blossoms from which they get their name. The seeds of the plant were found to contain a hallucinogen that causes powerful hallucinations which can persist for extended periods of time, perhaps even years. The hallucinogenic seeds of the White Claudia are known to have been used by Native Americans as religious ceremonies. The seeds were ground into a smooth paste later known as White Chrism. The people who used the seeds believed that the flowers had been granted by the gods as a means to call on them or connect with them via their souls. The hallucinogen itself was used only by shamans, but many people who did not use the drug asserted that the gods and their souls were connected just the same. The reasons for the mass hallucinations remain unknown. So this is the drug that they were testing on people. The drug that I'm pretty sure they tested on me. The Lost Landlord's Key. Okay, so is this key going to allow me to get into all the places I couldn't before, or what? I'm not exactly sure where to use this. I do know that there's a... Oh, you know what? I think I know what it's for. Yeah, I think I know what it's for. I think it's for the front entrance down here. Yeah, it's gotta be for this. And the game just crashed. Uh-oh. I hope that's not a repeatable crash. Okay, let's try this again. Come on, please, please, please. Oh, it went completely silent. Oh! What the hell? It popped up for like just a second. I saw the outside world and then it crashed. Third time's the charm? Come on. Third time is not the charm. Oh. There we go. Fifth time is the charm, I guess? Okay, it finally worked. I didn't really do anything in particular. I was gonna load up an older save game from like 20 minutes previous and try to make up the what I'd done in the meantime and then just do it again. Like, you know, maybe doing the quests or whatever you want to call them in a different order would make it work. But instead of that, I realized that there's actually a save point on floor 1. Because before I was loading the save point from the stairwell on floor 3, I believe it was, and then going down to floor 1 and then trying to open this door. But there's actually a save point on this level, on level 1, inside of one of the rooms. So I loaded the save point in the stairwell, then went down to the save point on level 1, saved there, opened the door, and it seemed to work. I hope to God I can find another save point before something else maybe happens, just in case it decides to crash when I open another door. Okay. So I think we're good. Yeah, everything's good. Okay. Alright, so I think I've made my way around the street that was completely broken, I think. At least I certainly hope so. If not, then I think everything I just did was completely pointless. Yeah, I think I made my way past the barrier. I think I'm on the other side. Okay, so this is just a dead end over here, right? Yeah, another barrier. Ah, here we go. A save point, thank God. So eerie to be traveling through these streets without a single person. Just almost literally a ghost town. Oh, I think that. Oh, yeah, the noise filter got turned off because I restarted the game. The key fits. Oh. The key is for that. Hold on. Before we go through there, let's see what else is here. Yep, this is the other side. Okay, let's go. Public parking. What public? Call for admittance. Should keep that in mind, just in case I find a phone. Maybe I need to dial those numbers? I doubt it, but maybe. Maybe it's like the apartment where if I dial the number, it just automatically opens, as if somebody answered it. The Green Lion. This is the place. This is the place where my character seems to think Dr. Kaufman might be, and also one of the places where they distributed the drug. Ah, the game crashed again. What is going on? Second try is the charm? I think this is good. This is loading. That's better than... Yeah, okay, it actually worked. Let me just turn on the noise filter again. I am now absolutely terrified of doors. Dr. Kaufman, why is there a hole in the wall? Dr. Kaufman. Oh god, this is really claustrophobic. I don't like this. Oh no, mannequins. How far down does the rabbit hole go? It's strange. Her left leg looks like it's separated from the rest of her body, like it was cut off and reattached, but the right leg looks like it's still attached, like fully. Like someone's been sawing up mannequins and swapping parts.
Sometimes the scariest thing to look at is yourself.
It's always easier to blame somebody else than to blame yourself. Mirrors and mannequins, mirrors and mannequins. Jesus. Oh my god. That's such a classic scare, but it actually got me. It actually got me. This game's been so restrained with its horror that it actually surprised me, and that's to its credit. It's been so restrained. Incredibly restrained. Which is refreshing, and it makes something like this actually possible. Because this is a total horror cliche, having mannequins that move when you're not looking, but it actually got me. I should just not look behind me, no matter what I hear. Just don't look. Just don't look. I think I need to play Dr. Frankenstein.
Got into a car accident and they're all gone now. I was driving the car at the moment and it's not my fault. I had a damn seizure while driving. All because of Dr. Kaufman's drug. He gave me the seizure. It's his fault. In his fault alone.
God, now I'm on the ceiling. Oh, this is all wrong. I wasn't there before. Loading. Loading. Okay, please, please don't crash. Please don't crash. Please don't crash. Oh, it didn't crash. What the hell is that? For prompt control of senile agitation. Old Freeman. Thorazine.
Is there someone? Anyone that can help me?
Man and a woman's soul in one body creates a situation of constant antagonism. They limit each other. If one begins to dominate, the other recedes and vice versa. In the book Su Wan, it is written the yin is eternal struggles, whereas yang is external turmoil. Yin knows the internal environment, and yang external displays. When yin and yang collide with each other from within and without, a phenomenon occurs that creates feelings of both emptiness and fulfillment, thus causing yin and yang to replace another. Yin and yang are never at rest. They constantly supplement and change each other. If yang recedes, then yin expands. And if yin recedes, then yang expands. The concept of yin and yang should be taken into consideration as an integral approach for any phenomenon involving unity. So, things must be kept in balance, otherwise everything will go wrong? Up or down? Well, basements are always fun. Ooh, save point. Okay, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end this episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.